now 4:30 in the morning. I've been up for a little while. I have been so sleepy the last 24 hours. I slept through Zumba. I know you're going to think I did that on purpose, but I didn't. I actually set my alarm. And I got up. I got up long enough to have a steamed potato with Frankie for dinner. And I went right back to bed. I literally went right back to bed and I slept until 3 something. So I don't know. I've just been so tired. I don't know what the heck is going on. This is so unusual for me to take naps like this and to sleep. But the last few days have been kind of crazy like that, where I've been sleepy. And yesterday was a real crazy day as far as my sleep went, because I slept, I feel like, half the day away and half the night. So anyhow, I'm just sitting here now waiting on time to pass for Zumba, because I will be going to Zumba this morning at 9:15. So that, and I'm waiting on you to call. But I don't know. Today you said you don't know when you'll call. Can you see this, what I did? Man, I burnt my forehead somehow with the flat iron, and I got a scab. And I was like, oh, man, I didn't remember burning it. And sure enough, yesterday morning, I must have done it again, and I didn't even feel it. And now I got blisters sitting there. What the heck? Am I a grown-up with a flat iron or a 5-year-old? I don't know. Anyway, so I'm just sitting here waiting on you this morning, waiting on you to call, waiting on time to pass, and I don't feel quite as tired, although I do honestly feel like I could lay back down and go back to sleep, but I'm afraid to, because I'm afraid I'll miss Zumba. But anyhow, all right, I love you, and I'll talk to you after a while. I hope you're having a good day, baby. Hey, babe. So I'm still just sitting here with my bedhead. Isn't that pretty? Beautiful. You're messaging me, but not calling, so I'm assuming that you're busy. I know you had duty today, so I guess I probably won't hear as much from you, so that's disappointing, but I understand. I'm just sitting here feeling a little dissatisfied with my life, thinking, like, things are passing me by. I'm gonna have to figure out something big to do. How can I mean, I'm halfway to dead already. My life is half over, because there ain't no way I'm living to be 100, so that's just how it goes. And, yeah, I haven't done anything major or big, or I haven't cured anything. I haven't played any musical instruments. I haven't danced on Dancing with the Stars. I haven't done anything great yet. So what am I going to do? I'm going to have to do something. I have to do something so I feel like I achieved something in my life. Anyway, we'll tell you what the next big idea is when I come up with something that I know that I want to do. Anyhow. All right, I love you. I'm just sitting here with my wheels turning, smoke coming out of my ears, thinking hard, trying to figure out what to do with myself. Am I making you nervous? Kind of makes me a little nervous. All right, baby, I love you. I can't wait for you to hurry up and be able to talk to me. I'll talk to you later.
Hey, babe. I got some crazy bedhead going on. I'm going to Zumba just like this too. I'll probably try to like fix it so it doesn't look quite like I just climbed out of bed, but I go to Zumba with bedhead because I just don't care. Can I just say how awesome it is to wake up in the morning and to know that you're going to call, and then you call and I get to talk to you for a while, and it's so nice. It's so nice. The only thing better than this was if you were home. But since you can't be home, I'm really grateful that we've had these days. I know that the days are coming to a close that you'll be able to talk to me, but it's been really amazing to have this time, and I'm super grateful for it. I wish that time was going a little faster than it is. It had seemed like it was moving pretty quick here recently, but then all of a sudden it feels like it's crawling. I don't know what's going on, but maybe because my days haven't been so busy. I've been so tired, like just sleeping and not being able to get it together. I don't know. So, but anyway, it's super, super awesome to hear from you and to be able to talk to you and see your face in the morning. It's awesome. Even though you're getting the full effect of me climbing out of bed, but whatever. I think maybe I got to stop sleeping in a bun. I fall asleep exactly with the same hairdo that I spend the whole day in. I hardly ever wear my hair down, but the weather's been so bad, you can't wear it down anyways. But look at that crazy something I got going on. I might have to fix this a little bit before I can go to Zumba. But anyhow, so I just want to get on here for a minute and tell you how much I love you and how nice it is to talk to you in the morning and to look forward to another call during the day. gives me something to look forward to for sure. But I guess I'm going to get my butt off here and figure out something to eat because I don't want to go to Zumba starving. I don't want to go be full because then your stomach hurts, and I don't want to be uncomfortably hungry either. So I got to figure out something and hopefully not wake Frankie up in the process. So I've got to fix something that doesn't require the blender, I think. But anyhow, I love you and I miss you, and I'm so glad I got to talk to you, and I'm looking forward to the next call. All right, baby, I'll talk to you later. Oh, babe, this is going to be one seriously green peanut butter and banana smoothie because I put the spirulina in it and spinach, and I just need a little something to get me through to go to Zumba. And so I'm not like crazy full, but yet at the same time, I got something in my tummy. So let's see how this turns out. I'm going to blend it up and see how green I can make a chocolate and banana smoothie. Let's see what happens. Green. We'll see what happens. But I guess that's what happens when you put dates and peanut butter and chocolate into. I can't get this thing off without using both hands. Ah! There, got it. But it does have spinach and spirulina in it, so it's going to be a good smoothie. I can smell it. It smells chocolatey. It's going to get me through my Zumba class. All right, let's see if I can do a pour while I'm holding the and not spill it everywhere. Oh, why is it so small? I didn't put enough liquid in it. Oh, look how little my smoothie is. That's so disappointing. Of course, actually, I don't need a real great big one because that'll end up making me sick in the pool. There's no reason to overdo it, I guess. There you have it. One army green smoothie. That's actually peanut butter and banana. There you go. What are you having for lunch today, babe? This is my breakfast, but you're on lunch for sure, past lunch now. All right. I love you. I'm heading to Zumba here in probably about 15 minutes. All right. I'll talk to you later. Look at all them dishes in the sink. Frankie found all these dishes in her bedroom. What kind of garbage is that? I hope she's going to come wash these things. And that is her popcorn bowl from last night. And then the coffee cup is mine, and the wine glass is mine from the night before last. But that's how long I left that wine glass sitting there. Anyhow, I'm going to have to get some things taken care of today. You look around like everything is a mess. Everything's a mess. Too much junk on the counters I haven't picked up. My desk is a mess. About zero organization going on here. The table's a mess. I don't even know. I got a disaster going on. It's time to clean up, I think. All right, well, let me go drink my smoothie and get going to Zumba. I love you, babe. I'll talk to you in a little while. Hey, babe. So today won't be a short video because I just keep videoing today. I'm sitting here gulping down this smoothie as fast as I can go. I definitely didn't put enough liquid in it, and that's fine. Not a big deal. That'll keep me from having to pee while I'm in the pool. Anyways, there's nothing worse when you gotta go to the bathroom and you're still in the pool and you're like trying to do your workout, but you have to go to the bathroom, so that's good. I usually drink too much probably before I go, so I'm trying to burn the last of the gas out of the can. Not that that's really productive because I'm just have to pay for more gas, but it makes the can lighter for me to carry downstairs. So anyhow, I'm getting ready to head out of here and I'm taking my butt to Zumba. Here we go. All right. I love you, baby. So, babe, I'm sitting here at Zumba, and nobody's here yet. So I hope the class wasn't canceled, but I do see them moving the ropes in the pool. So maybe pretty soon, but I'm actually here early. Look at me here with bells on. There's not a single soul here. So it is what it is. But they're moving the ropes now, so they must be getting ready. Oh, it is the teacher. Good. All right. Let me go see if I can give her a hand. All right. Love you.
Hey, baby.
So I just finished Zumba. Well, I didn't just finish. I got in the hot tub for a little bit, and I was a little bit crazier today. Today's class was a little harder. I almost lost my bathing suit, which was the excitement of the day for everybody. That was fantastic. And, yeah. And then I sat in the hot tub for a while after. Oh, and I also had to get out of the pool in the middle to go to the bathroom. Because, of course, no matter how much I went to the bathroom before I got there and went twice after I got there before I got in the pool, I still had to go. Because I got, old lady had too many babies bladder. So I had to go to the bathroom in the middle of the class. That kind of sucked. That's the first time I've ever had to do that. It was a little embarrassing. But yeah, so Zumba was fantastic. I love it, love it, love it. And now there's a Monday night class that another lady that I know is going to, so I'm gonna try to make that class too. And oh, there goes EMS. Anyway, so now I'm heading home to go get a shower, and I'm gonna go get the gas cans filled, and hopefully you'll be calling me at some point. All right, I love you, baby. So I'm just sitting here now waiting on you to call me back because you had an alert go off while we were on the phone. And I heard it. It didn't sound good. So I hope everything's okay. But anyhow, I'm just sitting here. I never did burn the gas out of that first can this morning. I just didn't have time. I'm still sitting here with it burning. So there must have been more in it than it seems like there is when it says it's in the red, you know, almost on empty. But you were on the phone with me. We were FaceTiming. Now that should probably, well, anyway, we were FaceTiming, but you know that I went and got gas in the other can. So anyhow, yeah, so I'm just sitting here waiting on you to call back, hoping it ain't going to be too long, but I don't know, by the sounds of things, it might be. I don't know what else. You know, Frankie doesn't get off until, I think she said 7 o'clock tonight, so just be me sitting by my lonesome. I don't have anything I have to do. I don't even have, oh, I do have laundry. I was going to say, I don't even have any laundry, but I have my bathing suit, which is sitting there wet in a bag right now. I need to actually go do that. Yep, I better get off here and go do that, because me and my no-track mind, I can't keep a train of thought for nothing. Nothing in the world. It's ridiculous. In 5 minutes, I'll forget what I just said. Anyhow, and I forget what I'm thinking all the time. But, yeah, so let me get off here and go do that. Anyway, I hope you can call me back soon. All right, I hope everything's okay. I love you. Hey, babe. So, it's now 3:30. And you still haven't called back, so I'm going to make myself some early dinner. I'm going to make an acorn squash, and I'm going to have some quinoa with it. So I already started the quinoa, but I'm going to steam this squash. It's the easiest thing on the planet to do is to steam that squash in the steamer. Sorry, you're looking at the wall for a second. I'm trying to get the seeds out of here. Just give me a minute. I'm coming back. Now I'll just fast forward through that. I gotta do the other half too. Sorry. Maybe I don't say anything important. We can just power right through that, and I'll just fast forward through that section or something. Okay. All done. The question is, what do I want to season this? Let me think about that for a second. What do I want to do this with? Think I'll do it with cumin. No, I better not. You know what? I think I'm just gonna do it with salt and pepper because I've got some pretty heavily seasoned quinoa. So. My kids are in the rain, drive spiders.
take that call from Frankie. But
see my squashes? They cute.
I love these little squashes. I don't make them very often, but every once in a while they're good.
I'm just gonna steam them real quick.
Steaming seems to be the healthiest, best way to go. Although roasting, to me, sometimes I'll put stuff in the oven afterwards just to give it like that, so it seems like it was roasted.
We'll see. Anyhow, that's all I'm doing.
I'll make this food and hopefully you'll call at some point.
I hope.
Got my quinoa going.
Well, I'll get back on here in a little while. Hopefully I'll have my
food done.
And I'll show you what it looks like. All right, love you, baby. Hey, babe, so this is...
Hey.
Just good night.
We love you.
Good night from the island.
She's a good hand.
I might be in trouble, babe. I don't know.
Nah, you're not in trouble. She's a good hand.
We love you, man.
Mike's leaving us, going down to Georgia. No, you're going down to Florida.
Florida. Getting out of the cold weather, finally.
All right, babe. I love you. Good night.